Ready for opening tip-off as they're doing the starting lineups for both teams. Just a quick rundown of the starters for tonight's game for the Pilgrims. It will be at the guards, Knapp and Lee. At the forwards, Kastner and McCramer. And at center is Mercer. At the two guards for the Zebras, Streeton and Garrick. At the forwards will be Odell and Korn. And at center is Luke Kennedy. So, as we're about ready to get underway here, Jason, and how's the atmosphere tonight? How do you feel?
It's actually a lot better than I thought it'd be. The Zebra crowd's pretty amped up. Quick observation, nice to see the Pilgrims have moved away from the Scott Kyle version jerseys.
Yeah.
And it looks like Coach Bales has them in some new apparel, but it's actually a pretty good environment, both student sections hopping, so we'll see. Should be, maybe if the Zebras can get the crowd behind them early, it could be a key to this game.
You have to admire, you know, breaking tradition. It's not an easy thing to do, and Bales comes in, he's going to do it his way, and that's what he did. A little different jerseys, nothing crazy over the top, but it's just not your traditional Plymouth uniforms. Rochester's going to come out in white jerseys with black and gold trim, very classy and clean look. Same thing with the Pilgrims, red jerseys, white trim, just real clean from both teams. True Indiana jerseys, that's what they are.
And the biggest difference between the old regime of Edison is that the shorts actually go below the knees on some of these players.
Yeah, Skiles, that's what you meant by Skiles S jerseys. So we got a first quarter score right now. Some of the games going on in the area. McConaughey leading North Miami 13-0 in the first quarter early. And Caston up on top of Lewis Cass, 28-26 in the Cass County Invitational. Good start for the Comets. Both teams take the court. We're about ready to get underway. You look at Mercer out there towering over everyone. Kennedy at 6'4", though, is next closest for the Zebras as they step into the center. Kennedy and Mercer to start this game off as the 0-1 Zebras try to topple the 2-0 Pilgrims. Tips up, right off the bat, right down the court is number 14, Joe Knapp. He lays it right in. It's 2-0 Pilgrim, and they're going to come out and do a full court press. Pass goes into Streeton as he's going to bring up one-on-one with Lee. Lee slips, and Streeton gets up the court. Top of the key, passes off Odell for jumper from the wing, got it partially deflected, pulled in by Kennedy, off the corner, but he has it stolen away, and here comes Kastner. Kastner up the right sideline to the right wing, stops right in front of Mercer, swings it back around to the top of the key, and they're going to reset the offense. Now Mercer right wing, up top is Lee, and back off to Knapp, and to the left wing is Kastner. Back up top to Mercer, fakes right, goes back left. Lee on the left wing, looking for the pass. Good defense so far from the Zebras on this possession. Reset from McCramer. And he's going to give it off. Now in the post to Mercer. Good front defense by Kennedy. Forces Mercer out, but he makes a nice spin. Floater in the lane. No good. Rebound comes off to Korn. Now ahead, Streeton, pass ahead to Odell. Odell stops, pops from 15. Bank is no good, and the rebound comes off to Kastner. Quickly ahead, here comes Lee. Stops, gives it off, layup is up, and good from Joe Knapp, and it's 4-0 Plymouth. Streeton up the court, gets across the timeline. Here comes a trap from Plymouth as he crosses. Picks up his dribble, skips it across to Odell on the right side. Jonathan Odell, right wing, crosses over. Gets cut off, spins back, good defense, gives it off to Korn on the right wing. To Korn, top of the key. And we're going to get see what the call is.
Looks like a 3 second, I believe.
3 seconds on the Zebras. I believe that was on Kennedy. So another turnover for the Zebras here, 4-0. Pilgrims lead here, 6:27 to go here in the first quarter. And bringing up the court will be Joe Knapp. That brings it left. Man-to-man defense right now from the Zebras. Mercer, right wing. Let's give it back up top. Reset the offense by Kastner. Now left wing. Here comes Knapp. Right to the basket. Dishes off to Mercer. Mercer's layup, no good. Rebound. And it's going to go off of the Zebras and out of bounds. And it's Plymouth ball.
Mercer's taking two early shots inside the paint, but Zebras done a good job earlier. I think Candy first him out 3-point line, made him drive, and now he had three guys in his face on the last one. So they're doing good so far.
Inbound pass going to come in deep near midcourt, and this is Knapp. resetting the offense. Now he's got Mercer one-on-one in the post against Kennedy. Nice spin baseline. Little left-handed dump, and it's good. 6-0 Pilgrim. Zebras to inbound. Creighton, actually it's Odell to inbound. Full court pressure from the Pilgrims. They get it in. Garrick is going to bring it up. Crosses over. May have gotten away with the carry. Gives it up the corner. Seth Korn, shot for three is blocked by Mercer. And then Garrick gets it, and I think he is fouled, I believe, or we're going to see here what the call is. Well, I'll tell you what, Korn is 6'2", lined up, took the shot. Mercer was halfway between him and the bucket and still blocked the shot.
Came out of nowhere, put that one almost for the stand, even saved it.
Odell to inbound. First foul of the game, and that's going to go against Ike Kastner. Greeting with the ball as he takes the inbound, goes left, gives off in the corner to Garrick. He's fumbling it, and it's going to go out of bounds. Too many turnovers already off the bat for the Zebras, I'd say.
Yeah, not the recipe for success, especially against a team that is outmanned you.
5.5 to go, first quarter, 6-0. Pilgrims with the lead here. Lee gives it off. This is Knapp now, left side. Looking in the post to Mercer. Nobody's on him. Finally finds him. Kennedy recovers. He backs down Kennedy. Left-handed hook is good off the glass. Fundamental basketball so far from the Pilgrims, and they see an 8-0 lead here early on. Garrick brings up the right wing. Stumbles a little bit. Falls to the ground. Keeps his dribble. Gets back on his feet. Screeton, top of the key. Stops, turns around, gives it back. Good pressure from the Pilgrims, really causing the Zebras to panic. Now we're going to get a blocking foul on McCramer as Korn tried to dribble baseline.
Early on, you can tell Plymouth is just a lot more physical right now than the Zebras. That could be a key part. If the Zebras want to stay in this one, they're going to have to step it up.
Coming in for the Zebras, the 5'7 freshman, Alec Holland. He's got a bright future for the Zebras. He's going to replace Screeton. Into inbound, this is Odell. Double bouncer to Korn out near the volleyball line. Now back up top to Odell. He goes right to Holland. Holland fumbles it out of bounds. Another turnover for the Zebras. And with 4:51 remaining in the first quarter, we've got an 8-0 Plymouth lead as they've got the ball again. Knapp brings it up for the Pilgrims. Mercer way outside the arc. Right side, back up top to Lee. Now left side. And this is Kastner. Back up top. They're going to swing it around to right side Lee. In the post, Mercer double team. They're going to get a foul. Good call by the official there is, let's see who they call it on. Could have been on Garrick or Kennedy, and they're going to get Kennedy with the foul. A little too aggressive in the post.
Yeah, but that's a foul you can almost live with in your coach Reinhold down there, bodying up on the double team. Just keeping the ball out of Mercer's hand.
Jacob Hadashell checking in for the Zebras as Korn is going to take a seat. As we see, Mercer's going to check out along with Kastner, and we'll change for the Pilgrims. Anders in. As the inbound comes in, we've got Lee going baseline, and we're really tight roping it. He's going to get fouled on the drive, and they're going to get Garrick with the foul there. Second team foul on the Zebras, two so far for the Pilgrims. That's the first on Garrick. As Gabe Vervink goes to inbound for the Pilgrims. They're going to bring it up top. Vervink retreats. They're going to swing it right side to Lee. Lee, nice move. Goes baseline. Takes it right against the Zebras. Layup is in and out. No good. Rebound comes off to Garrick. And here comes Holland the other way. Back up top. Garrick at the volleyball line. Zebras set the offense. He goes right. Jump stops in the lane. Kicks it back out. Odell, quick shot on the three. Bank is no good. Rebound Kennedy. Kennedy turns. Hands off to Odell. Fumbles a little bit. Reverse layup is no good. Rebound. Lee and Vervink actually fight for it. And Lee comes away with it for the Pilgrims. And we're going to get a travel, actually, as he passes ahead. McCramer turns, caught, and he didn't dribble before he took a step.
And we have a couple substitutions for the Zebras as Cyrus Hall and cousin Alex comes in, and Jacob Hodgeshell, the other. He's a young sophomore, actually, big football star, and Coach Reinhold takes the first time out.
30-second timeout for the Zebras. We'll keep it right here since we've missed about half of it so far. But, yeah, as you mentioned, we've got two Hollands on the floor now, Cyrus Holland, the junior, and Alec, but what does Alec bring as a freshman? He's got some promise, doesn't he?
Yeah, he plays with a lot of heart. He's fast. Looks like he has a good skill set. So as he develops, it'll be interesting to see. Take it back to the way he sits, though. You see, nice design by Coach Bales, who knew he had the height. He was going to win the tip, set it up perfectly on a play where he tipped it right to the streaker for the layup coming down the sideline. So
well-drawn up play there. The Zebras are looking to inbound. 8-0. Pilgrims lead midway through this first quarter, 3:57 remaining. And the Pilgrims defense showing pretty well, although the Zebras shots just haven't fallen. There's been a few there. Struggling to inbound against the pressure. They finally find Alec Holland, who stops just over midcourt, swings it over to Cyrus. Cy Holland to Alec Holland. He's going to spot in the corner for three. No good. Long rebound. Comes off to Korn, who just checked back in, but he pushed, like Jason says. And that's going to be an offensive foul on the Zebras.
Pulled that move plenty of times in my day.
You patented that move, I'd say, yeah. So that's the first on Korn, Seth Korn, third on the team. And the Zebras still with a big goose egg on the scoreboard. They're going to trap. Good rotation so far from the Pilgrims to break it. They're going right in the post, back out. Good ball movement, but now we got a trap in the corner, and they're going to get Josh Anders steps out of bounds. Good pressure there from Seth Korn.
Yeah, that's the kind of thing the Zebras have to do, get those traps in the corners as Hoschel inbounds to Holland.
Alec Holland brings it up, skips it ahead to Cy Holland. He's going to skip it across to Odell on the right wing. Looks in the post, dribbles baseline, stops, pops, and 10. Good, and the Zebras are on the board. Pilgrims the other way. Stop, pop, through. Tough shot. There's a lot of contact. No foul. And Odell comes away with the rebound. Brings it up against two Pilgrims. Gets the free throw line. Kicks in the corner. And with three on the way, is no good. Airballed by Cy Holland. And here come the Pilgrims the other way. In the post. Backing his way in, that was Anders. Back up top of the key. Long two is good from Joe Knapp. 10-2 Pilgrims lead here in the first quarter at Rochester High School. And now we got Holland picks up his dribble way outside the arc. Gives it ahead to Cy Holland. He goes, skips it across baseline. Odell goes into power dribble, and he's going to get called for the charge here. It's a good step up there by David Lee to take the charge.
Early on, you can tell the pressure on the Zebra guards is causing a struggle because they're missing guys wide open under the basket. They can't just see because they're too worried about keeping on their dribble. So we'll see if that'll continue to be a factor because there's two or three layups that have been missed that would have been wide open if they could have their head up to connect on the pass.
Zebras are going to go a little bit of a zone defense here with Odell checking out, Garrick back in, and Mercer checks back in for Plymouth. So a very tall lineup compared to Rochester right now for Plymouth. Lee left wing in the post, and this is Anders dribbling in, tries to find Mercer, can't, and it's stolen by the Zebras, and it's Jacob Hadeshell. He's going to bring up the court, cross the timeline, top of the key, dribbles in the lane, kicks it off, Seth Korn spots up, three on the way, good! The big man can shoot, and it's a five-point game just like that. Plymouth the other way. This is Vervink with the ball. Just top of the key to Mercer. Now Lee in the post. This is Anders. Power dribble. Good defense from the Zebras, but Lee, nice little teardrop, drops it in, and it's 12-5 Plymouth. Hadeshell fumbling the ball. Still has yet to cross midcourt. Picked it up, double dribble. Yep. Good call by the official. He dribbled off the back of his leg, turned around, picked it up with two hands, and then put the ball back on the floor. So another turnover so far on the Zebras.
Checking back in with the Pilgrims.
We're going to get a substitution. Ike Kastner is going to check back in for Plymouth. And David Lee will take a seat. 1:47 remaining first quarter here at Rochester High School. Zebras trail the Plymouth Pilgrims 12-5. They're going to lob to the bucket to Mercer. Good defense so far from Garrick. Mercer pulls it in. Left hand is good. And it's 14-5 Plymouth. Mercer. And a little pressure, one-on-one pressure here from Plymouth as Alec Holland brings up the court. Backs his way in. Now here comes a trap. He gets bumped pretty hard. They're going to get a foul on Plymouth, I believe, on Vervink here. A little bit too much contact there, and that's going to be the third team foul now on Plymouth, and that's the second. Actually, they're going to get Kastner with the foul, not Vervink. Some substitutions here is Alec Holland and Garrick check out. We see Kennedy
and Creighton come back in.
And Creighton's back in for the Zebras. Creighton with the ball, brings it up the court, top of the key, takes a left wing. Good pressure from Vervink. Could get in trouble with a five-second call if he doesn't get rid of it. Finally, swings to left side. That was Cy Holland over to Seth Korn. Seth Korn steps back. Long jumper on the way. No good off back iron. Mercer comes away with an easy snag. Throws ahead. Korn intercepts the pass, but oh, they're going to get him with a little too much body. And the foul coming against the Zebra. But they threw it ahead to Trenton Bryles, who just checked in. Korn had a good jump on it, but Bryles regained his status there and cut him off. drew the foul. Odell back in and checking out. I believe that was Cy Holland. In the post, turnaround jumper, no good for the Pilgrims. That was Josh Anders. Rebound comes off to Kennedy. 1 minute remaining first quarter, 14-5. Plymouth leads here at Rochester High School. This is Odell from the wing. Has his shot partially blocked, it looked like. And the Pilgrims come away with the rebound. And the other way, this is Felke. He tries to give it off to Knapp, and it goes out of bounds. And it's going to be a turnover on the Pilgrims. Zebra basketball.
Now here we are, 50 seconds left. Coach Reinhold pulling down 9, 14-5. Could be a lot worse. I wouldn't be surprised if he holds it out for the last shot and tries and takes us away with a 7-point deficit in the second quarter.
That's if Plymouth allows him to. Good pressure so far as they bring it up the court. This is Screeton, who fumbles it, loses it, but it rolls into the hands of Garrick. 40 seconds remaining. Garrick takes in the lane, stops, pops. Tough shot over Mercer. No good. Mercer comes away with the rebound, and wide open down the court is Felke, as Tom Felke's going to lay it in, and the Pilgrims add to their lead. 16-5, 28 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. Screeton up the court against the pressure. Lobs ahead, Garrick. Mercer comes out to guard him. Stops, kicks it across, and this is Houdeshell. Houdeshell stops. Top of the key. Now dump inside. Kennedy makes a nice move. We're going to get a foul on the ball. I believe Verbink, who is overmatched by Kennedy in the post, is going to get called for the foul. Fourth team foul now on the Pilgrims. First on Verbink. Five team fouls for the Zebras here in the first half, so they're a couple away from the bonus already. The Pilgrims are. 16.3 seconds remaining, first quarter. Nice inbound pass to Odell. He goes up strong. Mercer comes over the top. Blocks the shot. Odell gets it back. Jumper from the wing is good. 16-7 now. 9 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Bring it up the court. This is Felke. Skips it across. Verbink. Back to Felke. Three on the clock. Back to Verbink. Three on the way. Good! And that's going to be it for the first quarter, as a good showing from the Pilgrims gives them a 19-7 lead over the Zebras. You're listening to Rochester Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROY.
Your Culligan man has asked me to talk to you about your water. Are there rusty stains in your sink? And does your water smell and taste bad? Then it's time to call your Culligan man and ask about a Culligan water filtration system, because clean water doesn't smell, but contaminants do. A Culligan system eliminates the elements that stain sinks and tubs while reducing corrosion and buildup in fixtures and appliances, so they'll last longer and save you some serious dollars. Right now, try a Culligan system for only $9.95 a month for the first 6 months. Call 574-223-2420 and say, "Hey, Culligan man." That's 574-223-2420, or visit CulliganFultonCounty.com. Culligan, better water, pure and simple. Don't forget Culligan's salt sale this Saturday morning. Cash and carry and save money too at Culligan, 5th and Madison, Rochester.
WROI Rochester.
At Smith, Sawyer, and Smith Insurance Agency of Rochester, they know anything can happen at any given time without notice. They also know that finding the right insurance for the right price is really pretty easy. That's why they are your local trusted choice agent, which means they have access to multiple insurance companies that offer competitive pricing and coverage. Call 574-223-2166 or stop by their downtown location at 124 East 8th Street. You can also visit them online at SmithSawyerINS.com. Since 1932, Smith Sawyer Smith Insurance has protected individuals and families from those unforeseeable events in life.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Start the second quarter, Zebra Basketball. Plymouth leads 19-7 as the Zebras inbound. We've got Garrick, who gives it back to Houdeshell on the right wing. Dribbles in, picks up his dribble. Back up top to Garrick. He's going to reset the offense. Dribbles in, jumps off the lane, dumps it off. This is Kennedy, whose shot is partially deflected by Mercer. Gets it back, and he's going to be fouled in the arm on the putback. And it looks like Kennedy is going to go to the line for the Zebras. And we'll see who it is. Irving with his second. Team fifth, both teams with five fouls right now. So Luke Kennedy, the 6'4 junior, is going to head to the line to shoot two free throws here. If I don't have any, don't know if I have any free throw stats yet for anyone.
Oh, yeah, you saw a little strategy there. Coach Reinhold come in. First place take four, they pound it down right underneath and get a foul and get the line. Something's going to start having some more, get some buckets inside. You go right. The only way to neutralize a big man is go right at him.
First one was missed by Kennedy. He had no statistics on free throws before this because he hadn't taken a free throw yet this season. He hits the second. He's one of two now in the season. And it's a 19-8. Lead for the Pilgrims. A little contact there for the Pilgrims. They bring it up. Mercer, triple team, goes up over the top. No good. Rebound is going to come off to Kennedy for the Zebras. Creighton brings it up the court to the volleyball line, now right side. Down to Cy Holland, or excuse me, Houdeshell. Down in the post, a fall-away jumper by Odell is no good off front iron, and the rebound's going to come away to McCramer. Right side, McCramer lobs into Mercer, a double team. Mercer turns around, has a strip, and it comes away to Streeton. Now he has it poked away, ball is loose, a lot of contact. Finally comes away to Verbink, who jumps off to Mercer. He's fouled. Bucket does not fall, but he's going to head to the line to shoot two, and they're going to say Kennedy with a little bit of a bump under the bucket. Kennedy, Reinhold, they don't agree with
the
that
way
call.
This game's been played, that was a real cheap foul there, a real barely bumped him at all. The possession before, he got mugged by three Zebras and no call.
Say the one before looks like more of a foul than that one.
I think the way the physical game is, the Zebras have to step it up a notch, and I'm not asking for dirty play, but you gotta get Mercer out of his comfort zone.
Mac Mercer to the line, shooting two. First one on the way is good. Okay, substitutions here for the Zebras. Seth Korn is going to check back in. Kennedy's going to take a seat and checking in for the first time for the Zebras. This would be Taylor Medina, the 6'2 sophomore. Also, I didn't see who else took a seat with Kennedy, but second one on the way is good. And it's 21-8 Plymouth here in the second quarter. 6:50 remaining. Skip ahead, Korn against the pressure. Dumps it off to Medina. Medina shot over Mercer. Mercer blocked it with his elbow. Now ahead, this is Lee in transition. Layup is good. 23-8, timeout. Coach Reinhold's seen enough. Timeout Zebras, 6:35 remaining in the second quarter. It's Pilgrim's lead, 23-8. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
When it comes to buying a home, you can draw on the experience of the mortgage lenders at First Federal Savings Bank. Since 1966, First Federal has provided financing to homeowners throughout the area. First Federal is locally owned, so loan approvals are made here and loan servicing is done in your hometown. Free pre-qualifications are available at First Federal Savings Bank, 301 East 9th in Rochester and 814 North US 35 in Winnemac. Offices are also in Plymouth, Bremen, Elkhart, and Mishawaka. First Federal is FDIC insured and an equal housing lender. Borrowers must meet underwriting guidelines and a delivery fee may be applied to the loan. NMLS 399927.
What would you do if they put you in power? Would you make toll roads free or use the express line when you have more than 15 items? How about lowering your gas prices? The BP Visa with Pump Rewards does just that. Use it virtually everywhere, and you can save when you fill up. Apply today at BP.
Account subject to credit approval. Restrictions and limitations apply. BP Visa credit cards are issued by Chase Bank USA N.A. See application located inside the station for pricing and rewards details. Purchases made at merchants where non-BP gasoline is sold do not earn rewards.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Rochester High School, Plymouth leads 23-8, 6.5 remaining here in the second quarter. The inbound against the pressure goes to no one. It's going to go right out of bounds past Creighton as he looked like he tripped on the inbound. So another turnover on the Zebras. Plymouth will have it right underneath their bucket.
Not the play excuse you want coming out of timeout if you're a coach or any coach for that matter. So we see Cyrus Hall check in for Jacob Houdeshell. And as the Zebras prepare to
defend this inbound, they're going to lob it right in the middle to Mercer. He lowered his shoulder. They're going to get him for a charge. Great job there by Streeton as he took the charge. And that was an easy one for the official because Mercer, he's going to have to dip pretty low to get his shoulder into someone.
Especially Streeton.
Yeah, especially Streeton, who stands at a whole 5'9". That's a foot difference between those two. Can't do any better than that. Turn the ball over when you're giving up a foot in the post.
Yeah.
Streeton gets the inbound against the pressure. Here comes the double team. He's going to two-hop it over to Cy Holland. Cyrus Holland up the right sideline. Stops. Gives it off. This is Garrick on the right wing. Leans in. He's going to dribble off. Good, tough pass to Holland. He's going to swing it left side. Screen three on the way. No good. Rebound Seth Korn. His putback is blocked over the top by Lee, who saves it from going out of bounds, but it goes to Garrick. Garrick now trying to get in the post. It's tipped. Stolen by the Pilgrims. Up ahead, this is Felke. Layup is no good. Rebound no good. And the Pilgrims are going to come away with the offensive rebound. Mercer top of the key. His three on the way. Good. He can do it all. 26-8, Pilgrims lead. Inbound goes to Garrick. 5:52 remaining first half. Throws ahead. Bad pass stolen. And up ahead, this is Felke. Gives it off. Mercer goes up for the dunk, and he gets undercut from behind. He's fouled, and he got it to drop somehow.
bad series there for the Zebras. Well, it looks like Selke took about four steps on that layup he missed earlier. It turned out to be a huge turnaround because the Pilgrims got the rebound, kicked back out to Murphy for three.
We're going to get the Zebra foul, and Carter Street, who tripped. Looked like Mercer was going to go up for a two-handed dunk, and he got undercut and almost turned into a dangerous play. And thankfully, everyone came out okay. Street and Garrick are going to take a seat as Medina checks back in along with Alex Holland. So Mercer to line to capitalize on this three-point play. And he nails it 29-8. Pilgrims lead here at Rochester High School.
The 10-0 run to start the quarter for the Pilgrims, not a good start for the Zebras.
No, not, especially after the bad first quarter. Alec Holland, nice stop. Tries to pass. The man who was on the ground was McCramer, who popped right back up and picked off the pass.
And they get Holland for a cheap foul going up for the ball.
So nice play there by McCramer, who actually slipped, popped right up, and picked off the pass, only to get foul by Holland.
Now we're two free throws here on out for the rest of the half.
Mercer, Felke are going to take a seat for Plymouth as McCramer is going to head to the line. 5.5 to go here in the first half. 1-1, first one's on the way. No good off back iron. Rebound comes off long to Medina. And he's going to hand it off to Cyrus Holland. Up the right side, here comes the trap from the Pilgrims. Actually, they back off, gives it over to Alec Holland. Holland's going to reset the offense, goes left, kicks it off. Odell pump fakes on the three, dribbles right, and we're going to get a blocking foul on the way, and that's going to be on McCramer, who got a little overzealous there and tried to draw the charge. Did not happen by the official.
And once again, while we talk about the pregame, Zebras is struggling to score here still in the second quarter, 8 points, and that's a problem in general. And then once you play this Plymouth defense, it's very physical, and in your face, it's becoming even more of a problem as Odell comes to the line.
Both teams in the bonus now. 18 fouls on the Zebras, 7 on the Pilgrims as Odell heads the line for 1-1. Jonathan Odell's free throw on the way. Good. Nothing but net. And he'll have a second one coming. Selke's going to check back in for Plymouth. And McCramer's going to take a seat. 5:15 remaining here in the first half. Pilgrims with a healthy 29-9 lead. Odell back to the line for his second. They've held him pretty much in check so far, the leading scorer for the Zebras. Second one off the back iron, no good. Rebound comes racing in as Lee. And here come the Pilgrims the other way. They're going to slow down the tempo here as Knapp walks across the timeline. Takes it right, gets a screen. Now takes it to the hole. Nice screen by Anders to free him up, and he takes it right in, lays it in. 31-9, Plymouth with the lead. Under 5 to go, first half. Streeton breaks the pressure, gives it ahead to Garrick. Now his pass just goes awry. Picked off by Lee. Ahead to Felke. Felke jump stops the lane, turns around, skips it across far side. And now we've got Knapp in the corner. Now he goes post. Anders moves to the left. Back out. Spots up. Knapp 3 on the way. Air ball, and that's going to go out of bounds. Zebra fans, actually something to cheer about here now after the air ball miss.
So probably even for 31 points in that quarter, that's only Pilgrim's second three-point attempt, I believe, now 50% on the night.
They're playing pretty fundamental basketball as the inbounds tipped out of bounds off of Bryles for Plymouth.
Like spell for the Zebras.
If they're hot in the three, that would make a lot of sense. But, yeah.
The point of the paint battle.
Long pass ahead to Garrick. Comes away with it. Turns around. Shot up off the glass. No good. Rebound. Off to himself. Put back is good and one. A tough battle there for Alec Garrick, but he gets it to fall, and now he's going to head to the line for a chance at the old-fashioned three-point play. 31-11, 4.5 remaining here in the first half. Garrick to the line for his additional free throw here. Free throw on the way is up, in and out, no good, but we're going to get a lane violation on Garrick, and it's going to go over to Plymouth out of bounds. Pressure from the Zebras here. They're going to go full court, man-to-man, it looks like, as Bryles goes to inbound. Finds Lee. Lee back to Bryles, who brings across the timeline. Left side, Knapp goes right to the hole, right through three defenders. He's going to be fouled on the layup. I think they got Streeton with the foul. He can't believe it. There's a Knapp was on a mission there to the bucket.
Zebra foul.
So that's going to send Joe Knapp to the line. Two free throws is in the act of shooting. 19 foul on the Zebras, second on Carter Street. So Joe Knapp, the
5'10 senior to the line. First free throw is no good. Mercer's going to check back in for the Pilgrims. And we're going to see Bryles take a seat.
That might be the only thing Plymouth hasn't done well tonight, is they've had a few miscues at the free throw line.
That's not like a typical Plymouth team.
No, that's an automatic 2 points every time they went to the line.
Typically. Second on the way from Knapp is good. He is 1 of 2, and it's 32-11. Plymouth with the lead here at Rochester High School. Another rough inbound pass to Screeton, and we're going to get a bailout call here on Tom Falke. He's going to be called for the foul. Really, that you can credit that to a bad pass on the inbound.
Number 42.
He did foul Screeton, and that's going to put Screeton at the line shooting 1-1. 19 foul for Plymouth now.
Yeah, it's really both sides at fault. The inbounder is not giving the guard enough room to operate once he inbounds it, but the guard's not doing a good enough job of getting open to give the inbounder an easy passing lane.
Screeton's free throw is good, so he'll have a second. Well, these officials are really calling it close, too, Jason. You're seeing usually you can chalk these two teams up to Big Ten style, really competitive. The officials usually let them play, but they are calling it pretty close tonight.
And it's really caused a lack of anybody getting real rhythm on the floor, even Plymouth, as Screeton's second free throw is missed, but the rhythm's really been thrown off with all the stoppages in play.
Like Jason said, Screeton's second free throw missed. Mercer came with the rebound. Garrick poked his hand in there, poked it out of bounds. Stays with Plymouth. 32-12, 4:20 remaining here in the first half. Plymouth with the lead. Skip far side, now in the bucket. Anders underneath, crowded underneath the bucket, gives up to Mercer. Mercer with the one-hand dunk, no good. Gets it back, shot is blocked by Odell. He gets it back again and puts it in. 34-12. This is Garrick, right, left side for the Zebras. Top of the key, dumps it off. Screeton, pump it, gets around Mercer, dishes off. Shot is blocked over the top. It was Cy Holland, came away to Anders, and Anders was standing out of bounds at the time, so it's going to stay with the Zebras.
Yeah, Mercer not accustomed. These Rochester rims are real loose. They came down hard on the dunk and popped his own dunk out of the basket.
Yeah, and then a nice recovery by Odell, who came to the top to block his second chance. But unfortunately, he had a third, and he finished it off. Turnover on the Zebras off the inbound, and coming the other way is Bryles. Gives it off. Anders underneath the bucket is going to be fouled on his shot. And it's going to be on either Screeton or Garrick here. And they're going to get Screeton with his third. Well, nope, it's Garrick. It is Garrick.
His second. So far, Zebras are struggling to protect the basket. I can understand for Mercer, but guards are just cutting that low post block from the opposite side and finding themselves wide open and getting the line or laying it in, and that's a major problem.
Anders' first on the line is way off the mark. He did draw iron, though. That's the lucky part.
Reminds me a lot of myself.
Garrick's going to check out for the Zebras. Corn back in. Second from the line from Anders is up, and that's off back iron. No good. Rebound comes away to Seth Corn. 3:40 remaining. First half, 34-12. Pilgrims lead the Zebras. Screeting up the court to Corn, right wing. He's going to back it back out to Alec Holland. Holland, between the legs, stops, pops from 15. No good, but he is fouled on the shot. Now they're going to say he was on the floor after the shot. There's a nice crossover between the legs there by Alec Holland, the freshman. Step back, fired, and when he landed, unfortunately for Bryles, he landed right on top of Holland. So that's going to send Alec Holland to the line, shooting two, as they're now in the double bonus. Both teams in the double bonus now, with 3:25 remaining in the first half. Holland's first is off the mark, no good.
Now that make a major difference in the score, but Zebra's still not taking advantage of the three ones at the line.
Especially when Plymouth's not hitting at the line either.
Exactly. I mean, there's probably four, I think I have down for four, maybe five missed free throws that can not make a huge difference, but be somewhat.
David Lee checks back in for the Pilgrims. Second one good from the freshman. And Alec Holland cuts the lead to 21. 34-13, 3:22 remaining in the first half. Up ahead, Bryles skips it across. Lee on the left wing pulls it back out. Good pressure from the Zebras. And a bad errant pass lands in the hands of Coach Reynolds. Out of bounds, turnover on the Pilgrims. So I'll tell you what happened there. Bad communication there between Lee and Bryles.
And just air melted like a Drew Brees pass.
Last night, you could say that. Five interceptions. Holy cow. Too bad you have him on fantasy, right?
Unfortunately.
Too bad I'm not playing you this week. Zebras with the ball top of the key. And this is Cy Holland. He gives it off. Odell completely around the arc. Jumps off the lane. Back out. Seth Thorne. He puts the ball on the floor. Turns around. Back to Screeton. Screeton pump fake. Takes the lane. Takes it hard. Tough shot. No good. Rebound comes off to Lee. Quickly ahead. Here comes Joe Knapp. Gives it off to Mercer. Mercer's going to be fouled on the floor by Cyrus Holland, who's trying to come over the top to poke it away.
It's always interesting to see a fast break like that with Mercer. Guy's known as the guy that can dunk it by dunk hard, being a 6'9 guy. You can see everybody's eyes lighting up in the gym and figuring out what Plymouth was going to do, but it turns out Cy ruins everybody's highlight real hope with that foul.
Well, Mercer's had a couple chances. The first one, he was undercut by Street, and the second one, he missed the dunk.
Yeah.
The 6'9 junior to the line, shooting two for the bonus foul. Hits the first, so we're going to get some substitutions here. Houdeshell and Medina check back in for the Zebras as Cyrus Holland and Odell check out. And it looks like Riles checks back in for the Pilgrims. Second one on the way from Mercer is good. And it's 36-13, 2:45 remaining first half. Pilgrims with the lead over the Zebras. Screeting up the court. A little pressure from Lee. Backs off. Brings it to the top of the key. Left side. Holland jump stops. Pops. No good. And we're going to get a foul underneath the bucket. It's going to be on Screeton, which is going to be, I believe, his third.
Yeah, that is.
A little push as that was Knapp who went up for the rebound. A lot of fouls here in this first half. As if the Zebras weren't in enough trouble already. Now they're going to worry about the foul bug. Knapp back to the line to shoot two here. First one on the way. It trickles in off the front iron. Carter Streeton's going to check out, and Alec Garrick's going to check back in. 2:33 remaining first half. Pilgrims with a 24-point lead, and Joe Knapp's looking to add on to it. And it's good. Second one. Get a substitution here for the Pilgrims. A couple new faces here. Evan Parkhurst is going to check in, along with Matt Flynn, the 6-foot junior. Not the Seattle Seahawks backup quarterback. Zebras with the inbound here. Jacob Houdeshell gives it back to Alec Holland, the freshman, up the court. Gives it ahead to Medina. Medina's pass is deflected. Pulled back in by Houdeshell. Right wing. Picks up his dribble. Good pressure so far by Flynn. Into a cutting. Holland, his shot is good up off the glass. Points have been few and far between, but some of these shots have been pretty good from the Zebras. 38-15, the score right now. Inbound pass was kicked by Garrick, so we're going to stoppage of play here. Kennedy back in. We haven't seen him in a little while. Medina's going to check out. Parkerson zounds, and Lee's going to bring it up. It looks like a trap coming from the Zebras, a 2-2-1 format. Lee gives it ahead. Here comes the trap as Flynn gives it back to Lee. Lee guarded by Houdeshell. Garrick comes to give pressure. Good pressure from the Zebras. Balls it loose. Holland ahead to Garrick. Garrick's layup is up and good. Good pressure from the Zebras, and Coach Bales does not like what he's seeing. He takes a full timeout. 1:52 remaining in the first half, and the Zebras trail 38-17. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Get smooth one coat coverage and a lifetime warranty when you buy paint at Innards True Value Hardware Store, 1619 Main, Rochester. Choose Easy Care Ultra Premium Interior Latex Paint with excellent one coat coverage and easy cleanup, or Weatherall Ultra Premium Exterior Latex Paint with stain resistance and great coverage, and get great savings. Find everything you need for your paint projects plus expert local advice at Enyard's True Value Hardware Store, Monday through Friday, 7 to 7, Saturday, 7 to 6, Sunday, 9 to 5. Enyard's True Value. Start right. Start here.
Being a parent has never been tougher. Life just offers too many choices and temptations. Many families find help by becoming affiliated with friends at their place of worship, and that is a great help. If you find your life is offering more questions than answers, why not join us at Grace United Methodist Church? We have services on Saturday at 5:30 p.m. and Sunday at 9:30 a.m. Child care is provided at both services. Our church is located at 7th and Jefferson Streets in Rochester. We welcome you to become a part of our church family.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Rochester High School, 1:52 remaining in the first half. Pilgrims with a comfortable lead, 38-17 over the Zebras. However, the Zebras on a little run of their own. It might be only be 4-0, but it's a run nonetheless. Lee's going to bring it up against the pressure. The trap got him last time. Force a turnover. He gives ahead to Flynn. Flynn is trapped. Here comes Holland. Ties it up. Or excuse me, that was Houdeshell. Ties it up. We're going to get a jump ball. Stays with Plymouth. Boy, that trap is starting to work pretty well for
Zubers. Yeah, it is. I don't think he was going to win that battle with Houdeshell, the gridiron star there. He wasn't going to win that loose ball fight.
Inbound goes to Lee. Houdeshell top of the key. And now we got a trap. Here comes Garrick and Houdeshell. And they're going to get, a foul on Houdeshell. I thought that was a pretty good play to tie up the ball. Official was a little jumpy on that one to make that foul.
I don't know if he was calling the foul on the strip or the tackle afterwards, but either way, Houdeshell.
That's just good aggressive basketball, Jason. You and I both know that.
As a fan of that style of play myself, I absolutely love the effort.
It's called Big Ten basketball. Lee to the line, shooting two. First one is good. He'll have the second one coming up here with a minute 36 remaining in the first half.
I think the Zebras have the shooting percentage to be able to call Big Ten basketball.
That was the first foul on Houdeshell. As we see Jonathan Odell check back in, Seth Korn's going to take a seat. One more on the way from Lee as he tries to get the Pilgrims to 40 points here at the half. Second one up and rattles home good, 40-17. And we're going to get a 30-second timeout here from Plymouth. Like I said, 40-17 Plymouth leads. You're listening to Rochester Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
New Holland T7000 Series tractors from New Holland Rochester take tractor performance to new heights with groundbreaking power, best-in-class hydraulics, and high-visibility horizon cab. These 135 to 180 PTO horsepower tractors offer the new fast steer turning option, a must-have feature for row crop or loader work. It lets you make a full right or left turn with only a 10-degree nudge of the steering wheel. Step up to a new level of performance with a New Holland T7000 tractor from New Holland Rochester, Highway 25 South.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
So the halftime scores for you around the area. Lewis Cass leads Cass in 43-36. That's actually a final as they won the third place game of the Cass County Invitational. As the Zebras look to inbound, and it's Alec Holland racing up the sideline. Gives ahead. This is Houdeshell. Back to Holland. Holland top of the key, dribbles in. He's going to be fouled. Some contact there from, looks like Flynn. Other scores around the area. Columbia City leads Northfield 36-13 at the half. Peru leads Wabash 35-33. Norwell over top of Whitco 24-19. And McConaughey on top of North Miami 42-22. Additional score, Northwood leads Triton at the end of the first quarter 22-21. So that could be an, I don't know if that would be an upset if Northwood took down Triton, but Triton is a highly ranked 1A team. So.
Yeah.
Holland's first is good. They'll have a second one coming up here. 40-18 is the score right now. As the second one's good, 40-19, Plymouth leads Rochester with a minute and a half remaining here in the first half. That trap that's been working so well for the Zebras, they continue with it. Houdeshell against Bryles. Bryles in the post. This is Anders. Now he's trapped. Brings it up high. Good pressure from the Zebras, and we're going to get a jump ball. This is going to be Zebra basketball. Good play there from, I believe that was Houdeshell again over the top. And that football mentality kind of plays well in the trap. Minute 16 remaining first half. Alec Holland's going to bring it up. More pressure from the Pilgrims. He gives it over to Odell. Odell working his brows. Takes it right in the lane. Drops it off. Baseline jumper on the way from Houdeshell is no good. Rebound tipped by Lee. Hits the baseline. Wait, we're going to get a foul away from the ball on Odell. Nope, they're going to get a foul. Odell was fouled. And it's Bryles who apparently pushed him underneath the bucket. So that sends Odell to the line to shoot two as the free throw parade continues. Second on Bryles. Just over a minute remaining in the first half. First one is good from Odell. Cuts the lead to 20. He has the second one on the way. Odell's free throw is good. And it's 40-21. Plymouth lead. Back into the trap. Lee walks it up. 1 minute remaining here in the first half. Gives it ahead. Good tip and stolen by Odell. Throws it ahead. This is Houdeshell on the break against Lee. Stops. Bryles comes over the top and he's going to be fouled. And that's going to be the third on Bryles.
And this should be interesting. I haven't seen Houdeshell shoot free throws yet, but you get those football mentality guys that are here to play defense.
Not typically the most finesse players.
You always wonder how their free throw ability is.
So Houdeshell to the line, shoot free throws. First one, tried to bank it, hit back iron, no good.
That brings Mercer back in, who I'm thinking they're trying to rest the rest of the half.
And they're probably a good move there by the
kind
coach.
Kind of smolder any of a zebra run that's starting to creep up.
Yeah, Bales was frustrated with the trap, and now he's just had seen enough. Both missed by Houdeshell. Rebound comes out to Mercer, ahead to Lee. Lee back out, Knapp, right wing. Looks inside, trying to find Mercer. Going to swing it back around, Mercer in the left wing. Now the baseline. This is Anders. Tries to skip it back up. Tip by Houdeshell. Comes back into the hands of Mercer. Now Bryles right wing three on the way is good. 43-21. 30 seconds remaining in the first half. Alec Holland picks up his dribble well outside the arc. Trying to find someone to pass to. And Lee jumps the pass. Heading the other way on a fast break. He's going to be fouled. Layup is no good. But he'll head to the line to shoot two.
Yeah, Mercer substitution came in to be big there because Houdeshell hit the ball up and like eighth grader playing with kindergartner, he just kind of reached out and grabbed the ball and what could have been another zebra turnover, which led to the three. So big play there by Mercer as we have Lee at the line.
David Lee, first from the line of two. On the way, it's good. He'll have a second one coming, 44-21. 21.9 seconds remaining here in the first half. Lee's second from the line is good. It's a 24-point lead here for the Pilgrims. And they're going to continue full court press. Into Alec Holland, who turns up the sideline, burns three defenders, kicks off the Houdeshell back out. Odell's three on the way from the wing, lodges between the backboard and the rim. That's a jump ball, and Plymouth has possession. To worse there, I'd say. Just kind of the luck so far of the Zebras tonight. 10 seconds remaining. Knapp brings up against the pressure, skips over to Bryles. 8 on the clock, gets it back up top. Houdeshell can't come away with the seal. They're going to swing it left side. Lee with the ball, 3 on the clock, dribbles in, back out. Mercer, 3 on the way at the buzzer. No good, off the back iron. And that's going to be it for the first half of play. On the court for the Zebras, Odell, Garrick, Screeton, Korn, and Kennedy. For the Pilgrims, it's Knapp, Lee, Mercer, and I think the other ones were, if I can get to the right side. Yeah, we're going to get a Lee on a breakaway dunk while I'm still trying to figure out the rosters here. Breakaway layup.
Breakaway.
Sorry. 47-21 is the lead right now.
Sorry to excite our listening crowd.
The Kramer was the other one I was trying to think of. There we go. And, of course, Kastner. So we're going to get a stoppage of play here. I didn't see what the mix-up was here.
Were they only playing with four guys?
I believe the Zebras were playing with four guys. They finally got Alec Holland in the game. So no wonder they had an easy breakaway there. The Zebras, for the first 23 seconds of the game, or the second half, were playing with four guys.
Coach Riddle is trying to confuse the Pilgrim, see if that works for
him. Trying anything right now. That pass by Screeton is stolen, lobbed ahead, wide open layup for Knapp is good. Boy, Lee, you're right. Lee and Knapp are looking fantastic right now. They're playing a good two-man game, too.
Yeah.
You're worried about Mercer, and these two come in and really throw a kink in the game. Bad pass again for the Zebras. Stolen, and then knocked out of bounds by Screeton. 49-21, Plymouth continues to pile it on right now onto the Zebras.
Touchdown lead here.
It does look like a football score. Not usually these two. Usually it's a little more low scoring in football games. First in the post, backside, throws it off. Layup is good by McCramer. Alec Holland the other way, right at the sideline. Good cutoff by McCramer. Good defense so far by McCramer on that wing. As Holland throws it ahead, he gets trampled by Lee. Gets it back from Modell. Now he's trapped in the corner, trying to find someone. Regains his dribble. Dribbles in. Tough shot from 15. No good. Rebound tipped by Lee. Tipped around. Finally pulled in by McCramer. Boy, it's getting really physical out there right now. Mercer skipped over in the corner. This is Knapp. He's going to be fouled on a push by Holland.
Unless the cheerleaders over there reached in, I don't see much of a foul there by Holland after we let it get physical and then they call it.
Yeah, they call that one. And it's kind of been the theme of the game.
I've had a pom-pom catch him on the arm.
So it's going to be the first team foul on the Zebras here in the second half. Second on Alec Holland. Inbound goes right to Knapp, right underneath the bucket. Lane is good. And it's 53-21. Pass goes in to Odell against the pressure. Head to Korn. Set Korn up the court. Jump stops. Kicks it back over. No one there except for red jerseys. And it's stolen. Up ahead now. Now they're going to skip to the corner. Knapp for three. No good. Rebound. Tipped by Lee. Off of Korn's hand. Ball on the floor. Picked up by Kennedy. Now Screeton the other way. Right side. Boy, he's fumbling the ball. Trying to regain composure here. Back up top. Odell steps in. 18-foot jumper on the way. No good off front iron. Rebound pulled away by Mercer. Now Knapp, who runs right into Odell. Ball is tipped away and stolen. It's Screeton. Now Odell. Pump fake. Gets past Mercer. Takes it in. Layup is no good. A lot of contact against the bucket. No call. And once again, Knapp is common to say on that time. He was cherry picking. Wide open on the other side. 55-21 Plymouth with after that layup. Screeton has it poked away. Lee, another great defensive play. Ball's loose. Screeton gets it back, though. Now Korn, left wing. He's going to fire a three. No good off front iron. Rebound Knapp. Here he comes the other way. He's going to sleep all tonight. Up the court, he's going to be called for the charge. Great job there by Carter Screeton.
And so Spinal wants a timeout here.
Yeah, I think somebody needs to slow this game down. It's getting a little out of control. Garrick's going to check in, and we're going to get a timeout. 5:19 remaining, third quarter. Plymouth 55, Rochester 21. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
RTC's Fiber Connect is the leading scorer in the world of communications. Let RTC give you the safety of knowing you have touched down with a real winner when you sign up for cable television, high-speed internet, and telephone services. Don't pass this opportunity up and don't get blitzed by the competition. Cheer on the hometown team and call RTC at 223-2191 in Rochester or 598-2782 in Akron.
Call RTC in Rochester or Akron and become an eligible receiver for their winning Fiber Connect services.
If you're stuck with high monthly car payments and think it's the best you can do, think again. By refinancing your car loan with State Farm Bank, you may save on your monthly payments and have more money to spend on other things. Call State Farm agent Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017 for more information. Jeff will help you see how much you could save by refinancing with State Farm Bank. That's Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017. State Farm Bank, member FDIC. DIC Equal Housing Lender.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Pilgrims lead the Zebras 55-21, 5:19 remaining in the third quarter. Coming out of the timeout, what do you think Brian Hope was talking about in the huddle?
I think that's one of those speeds you just give where you got to just come out and play hard for the next 13 minutes or so and see where the scoreboard leads you and not worry about losing by how much or how many, but just battling.
Yeah, Screeton gets called for 5 seconds. It was great defense there by, I believe that was Kastner on the defense there. But Screeton just kept dribbling around. He really couldn't find an outlet to go. And Coach Hom on the bench there trying to give him directions. You got to get rid of the ball there. Kastner low post to Mercer. Mercer skips it across to Lee. They're going to swing around the arc. Back into Mercer. Mercer looking around. Dribbles in. Tough shot. Good and one.
That's the kind of thing the Zebras can't allow, because they always preach, that's one of the biggest things. You can't allow an entry pass from the top of the key to go to the post like that. That wasn't a lob ball. It wasn't really that hard a pass. He just straight chest pass. And that's one of the things the Zebras can't allow.
Yeah, they just gave him too much room. Kennedy picks up his third, team second. Mercer's free throw is good, and it's a 37-point lead here for the Pilgrims. Garrick up ahead. Now Holland, the freshman. Jumper, long two on the line. No good. Nobody's back for the Zebras. Mercer's got a breakaway. Holland tries to run him down. He's going to go for the layup, and it's good.
Holland's a brave soul.
He's given up about 14 inches there against them.
Risk being on fourth center, but he got Mercer to lay it in.
This is Garrick, left wing, looking to the post. Odell's posting up against Mercer. Actually, that's Kennedy. And Holland gets a little pressure, steps out of bounds, turnover again on the Zebras as Vervink and Anders check back in for the Pilgrims. And we're going to see Knapp and Mercer take a seat. Also in, Cyrus Holland for the Zebras. And Carter Screeton is going to take a seat. So Plymouth ball, they lead 60-21 here in the third quarter. And left wing, this is Anders. Skips it across. Vervink down the corner. As they dump it off inside. Bryles off to Anders. Anders shot, no good. Rebound comes away to Garrick. Ahead, Odell. Odell, tough pass inside to Holland. Good pump. It goes up. Maybe got away with a foul as Anders blocked the shot. I thought Anders fouled him there. No call, and here comes Plymouth the other way. up ahead. Kasser may have been fouled on the baseline or on the sideline by, looks like Garrick. And it was. So that's three now on Garrick. 13th foul this half now for the Zebras. And Plymouth will take it out on the sideline. How do you stay motivated here, Jason, when you're down 39 points?
Never been there.
Yeah, it's one of the benefits of...
this is the part where you usually coast it, have the JV guys feed Skittles and popcorn on the bench. I think it's just got to be a real teachable for Coach Vidal on a young team. And I think if you it's a position where you can get maybe a 10-2, 12-4 kind of run and maybe use some building points going on the next game.
So Kramer and Lee check out. In come Felke and Burbank as the lob to the bucket is turned over and the Zebras have the ball now. Oh, another bad pass to the Zebras, stolen. Here comes Kastner the other way. Stopped by Holland. Here comes Odell. They're trapped. Reverses out of there. Burbank has it stripped away and knocked out of bounds by Garrick. So Plymouth will have the ball out of bounds near midcourt. As Bryles inbound. This is Verving. Here comes the trap from the Zebras. A little over aggressive. Anders takes it to the hole, dumps it off. Bryles pump fakes, goes up, and he traveled. Yep. If he didn't travel, it's going to be a foul on Kennedy, but that would have been his fourth, but luckily he shuffled his feet right before it.
The Zebras are getting real aggressive defensively, doing a lot of wiping and hacking at the ball. It might really slow this game out even more.
Alec Holland up the court, left side, good defense, picks up his dribble, gives it up to Odell. Now Cyrus Holland left side. He dribbles back middle, kicks it over. Garrick three from the wing, good. Little glimmer of hope there for the Zebras, 60-24. Up the court, and a jumper from Kastner, no good off back iron. Rebound tipped around, pulled in by Kennedy. He was fouled from behind, and they're going to get Bryles with the reach in. Bryles trying to make up there, and... his call for the foul, that's his third, team second for Plymouth. So, Alec Holland, the freshman, will bring it up the court here. 2:57 remaining in the third quarter. Plymouth leads 60-24. Holland to the right wing. Heavily guarded. He's going to pass off. Garrick steps in. Long two from the baseline. No good off front iron. Battling for the rebound. Ball's loose on the sideline right in front of the Rochester bench. It's going to go off of... What's the call? I think the officials are going to have to discuss what happened here. The official is pointing to Alec Holland, but he didn't say who had the ball.
Make a real first down.
I thought it looked like it should have been Zebra basketball, and
there
that's
is.
What it is.
There's our first down signal.
So Zebras will retain possession here. Kastner will guard the inbound against Odell. Odell throws it backcourt near the back baseline as Alec Holland runs it down. Bryles picks him up at midcourt. He goes past him, takes it right, dumps off to Garrick. Garrick goes baseline, power dribbles in, layup, tough shot is good. Two and a half remaining third quarter, 60-26. Plymouth with the lead. Long pass is stolen by Garrick. Here comes Garrick the other way. Push ahead. 3-on-2. Tough layup is no good, but he's going to be fouled. And it's going to be against Verbeek.
I think your last couple minutes, you're starting to see that the type of player that Garrick can be. And that he's a real asset to the Zebras, but it gives credit to Lee and Knapp at how well they played defense and took them out of the game.
I think the first quarter, Garrick was a little bit tense, played a little scared, but he's starting to really loosen up, showing some skills here. Playing pretty well here in the third quarter. As he heads the line, he's going to shoot two as he was fouled in the act of shooting. It's nothing but net on the first one. And he'll have a second one coming here. 2:21 remaining third quarter, 60-27. Plymouth leads Rochester. That was the third team foul on the Pilgrims for this half. Second one off the back iron. Rebound Kennedy. His putback is no good, but he is fouled. And that's going to come against Anders. So that's the fourth team foul now on Plymouth. Second on number four, Josh Anders, the 6'3 freshman. So Kennedy to the line. He's going to shoot two here after he was fouled on the shot. First one on the way is no good off the back iron. I think we've noticed a lot of struggling from the line for the Pilgrims, but it looks like the Zebras have kind of struggled just equally as bad.
Yeah, they both have the same disease, and they're both hard off the back iron, maybe contributing nerves or a little tense.
It's been a hard battle, and sometimes you play hard and physical like that, the finesse game's lost. Parker checks back in for Plymouth as Kennedy hits his second. 60-28, 2:15 remaining, third quarter. Pilgrims with the lead. Nice rotation, but nice ball movement by the Pilgrims, but their pass is knocked out of bounds off of Cyrus Holland. Stays with the Pilgrims underneath their bucket. And it's going to be Felke to inbound. As both coaches call out their inbound plays, they find Burbank in the corner, wide open for three, no good. Rebound tipped around, saved underneath the bucket, goes right into the hands of Kastner. His shot is no good, but he is fouled. Actually, he might have been fouled on the floor before the shot. We'll see what the call is. And it's going to be against Odell on a hold. And they're going to say it was on the floor. Fourth team foul on the Zebras, second on Odell. 2:04 remaining in the third quarter. Quick pass in. Kastner goes up, blocked by Odell. And the rebound comes off to Holland, who traveled. Cyrus Holland turned with the ball, never put it on the floor, took a few steps. I'm not really sure where he was going on that one. He should have spun the other way. He hit a wide open lane.
To go anyway.
Yep. Pass goes into Parker. So they're going to swing it around. Bryles back in the corner. Kastner for three from the wing. No good. Rebound comes away to Kennedy.
That's the outbounds play he runs in sixth grade. Just hold.
Pass ahead to John Odell. Now Garrick trying to jump stop. Got a lot of contact. Had it ripped away from him. And they're going to say it was off of Garrick. Boy, I thought that was hit out of bounds by Plymouth. Nope. They're going to say it was off of the Zebras. And it's Plymouth ball. Boy, I can't get a break right now. 1:45 remaining in the third quarter. 32-point lead for the Pilgrims. Top of the key, Kastner dribbles in. Had to poke away. Ball's loose. Gets it back. Dumps in the post. This is Parker backing his way down. Shot off the glass. No good. Rebound comes off to John Odell. Odell ahead to Garrick. Garrick brings it back to the middle. Top of the key. Sets up the offense. Brings it against Verbeek. Now right side Odell. Takes it right to the hole. Tough stop. Shot off the glass is good. And the lead is now 30 for the Pilgrims. Here comes the trap from the Zebras. Irving ahead. Felke now to the short corner. They're going to swing it all the way around. And now skip across. This is Felke for three from the corner. No good off the side of the iron. Ball's tipped off of Garrick. And it's going to stay with the Pilgrims.
The corner three is just not very hot for Pilgrim. Do you think they try a new spot? That's where the shot comes over there.
Korn and Houdeshell are going to check back in as Kennedy and Cyrus Holland take a seat. Bryles inbounds to Verbeek. Back to Bryles. In the post. Parker's nice backdoor pass to Kastner, who's going to lay it in. A little finesse there from Kastner. And it's 62-30. Under a minute to go here in the third quarter. Alec Holland brings it up. Backs it up against Felke. Gives it off. Garrick takes the baseline. Turns around. Kicks it back out. Ball's tipped. And it's loose. And it's picked up. This is Felke going the other way. He's going to be fouled from behind by Garrick. And that is number four for Alec Garrick. So immediately, Reinholdt goes to the bench. And he's going to bring Carter Streeton back in. And Garrick will take a seat. 38.7 seconds remaining, third quarter. 62-30, Plymouth with the lead. They get the ball inbound here. Short corner, back up top. And this is Verbeek. They're going to swing around to Bryles. Down to the top of the key. Left side now. Long pass is tipped as Verbeek is trying to skip it across the Felke. Streeton jumps in the passing lane and knocks it out of bounds. 26.8 seconds now remaining in the third. Felke lobs to the bucket. Good finger there by Korn as he gets a finger on it. Knocks it out of bounds again. So now Plymouth will have it underneath the bucket. 26.1 seconds remaining here. 32-point lead here for the Pilgrims as it will be Felke to inbound. Lobs the top of the key. This is Verbeek as Odell brings out some pressure. Now Bryles. Here comes the trap from the Zebras. Odell and Houdeshell poked away. Odell to steal. Goes in for the layup. It's good. 13.2 seconds remaining. Here come the Zebras, or the Pilgrims the other way. Across the timeline, 8 seconds on the clock. This is Parkhurst way outside the lane on the baseline. Has a poked away out of bounds by Alec Holland. And with 5.7 seconds left, the Pilgrims will inbound from out of bounds underneath the bucket. 62-32 is the score. This is Falcon inbound. Finds Bryles. Bryles in the lane. Tough shot is no good, but he is fouled with 3.8 seconds remaining in the third. So that will send Bryles to the line. Trenton Bryles, the 6'1 junior. He's shooting two here as the foul is in the act of shooting. First one is good. He'll have a second on the way. That was the third foul on Seth Korn. Second one coming on the way here from Bryles. It is good. 32-point lead here for the Pilgrims, 3.8. Here comes Streeton. His half-court lob at the buzzer is no good, and that's going to do it for the third quarter. After three, Plymouth lead, 64-32. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Why purchase a new or pre-owned vehicle from Mike Anderson? This is John Adair, General Manager, and after visiting with a satisfied customer, this is what they told me. I never felt pressured. I appreciated the salesperson's honest approach. He explained why we might want to consider a different vehicle than the one we originally thought I wanted. I was amazed at how easy it was to get financed, and my salesperson took the time to explain all the features of my car before I even drove off the lot. So the fact is, at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram Truck, we want every one of our customers to say, I love my car, after the sale. We mean it when we say...
Thank you.
boy, he kind of got away with a few travels there, and now they're going to get the Zebra foul on the way. Good pressure from the Zebras. I thought he shuffled his feet, but nope, they're going to get, looks like, I didn't see the name. Oh, it was Alec Holland with his third foul. Team seventh, so it's going to be a 1-1 here. As Felke and Flynn check back in for the Pilgrims.
Tom Felke and Matt Flynn.
So to the line, this will be Zach Stone, the 5'10 junior forward. His free throw on the way is no good off the front iron. Rebound tipped around. Anders had a shot at it, didn't get it, and it comes away to Odell. Now ahead, Houdeshell fumbling it, somehow pulls it back in. Gives it back top of the key to Screeden. Screeden, crossover against Anders. Picks up his dribble, gives it back to Houdeshell, left wing, in the post. And we're going to get a pushing foul on Parkhurst as Kennedy had a shot at it. So that's only the team fifth for Plymouth. So the Zebras will take it out of bounds underneath the bucket. First on Parkhurst. Odell will take the inbound for the Zebras. He looks, finds Houdeshell in the corner. Dribbles back up top, picks up his dribble. Now skips it over to Screeden, top of the key. Guarded by Flynn. Looks inside. He had Kennedy for a split second. Lost him, and now we're going to get a foul, I believe, away from the ball. Or was it on the ball? It was on the ball. They're going to say Flynn got Screeden on the arm there. And now we're, no, I'm sorry, that last foul was the sixth foul. Now we're in the seventh foul. 1-1 bonus on the way for the Zebras now. And the second foul on Flynn. Screeden to line, shooting 1-1. Screeden's free throw on the way, in and out, no good. Rebound comes off to Anders. And up the sideline, we're going to get Flynn's going to be fouled by Screeden. As they said, Screeden grabbed a hold of his arm. Is that it for Screeden? Or four? So Garrick's going to check back in for the Zebras. With 6:03 remaining in the fourth quarter. Flynn to the line, shooting 1-1. 18 foul on the Zebras. Free throw on the way is good. They'll have a second. Reynolds at home. I would imagine Mercer's done for the night, but he had a pretty explosive second quarter. What is he looking at points-wise for the night?
Unofficially, 23.
Second one on the way is good from Flynn. And it's 68-33. Pilgrims with the lead. Garrick dribbles in, and he's going to be called for the charge. And that's going to give him, I believe, 5 fouls. Just say it, Jason. You don't have to say it, Bill. Just say 5 fouls.
I don't want to steal your limelight. But Mercer and Knapp have combined for about 40 points.
Yeah. Say Knapp, we talked a little bit about Knapp and Lee look very, very impressive today, pressuring the Zebra guards, the young guards. Gave him some fits. So Garrick fouls out, and back in comes Seth Korn. Plymouth breaks the pressure. Anders dumps it off, and Felke's going to pull back out to reset the offense. Try to run some clock, 5:45 remaining in the fourth. Stolen. Seth Korn steals the pass. Dribbles ahead. Nice backdoor pass to Jodell for the layup. 68-35. Plymouth with the lead here. Felke skips across. Flynn skips across to Felke. Now to Anders. Anders gets cut off. Ball's loose. Stripped away. Stolen by Alec Holland. Behind the back. What a play. Right to the rim. He's going to be fouled. Layup's no good. Hard foul for Matt Flynn. And that's going to put the freshman, Alec Holland, at the line, shooting two.
Nifty bit of dribbling there for the,
it was.
For the freshman.
That's a senior type of dribble there. It
takes me back to the days of pistol feet.
Had about three red jerseys around him, dribbled right out of him, had a breakaway layup, and Flynn came racing in and fouled him. But that puts Holland at the line, shooting two. He knocks in the first. That's the lead to 32 momentarily, as he has a second coming up here. Second one is good. Zebras back into a half-court trap as Flynn walks it up, stops at three-quarters court, and he just kind of surveys the land. Here's it ahead to Felke. Felke all the way across court. Stone is going to be fouled by Holland. Well, Kennedy came on the top and made a nice block on Stone after the foul, which still should count as a block because if he would have let it go, it could have been a layup and a chance for a three-point play.
Yeah, it looked pretty impressive block.
But it is a foul in the act of shooting, and Zach Stone's going to head the line to shoot a pair. 10th team foul on the Zebras. 4th one on Alec Holland, as we're going to see Cyrus Holland check back into the lineup. And Kennedy is going to check out. 5:09 remaining in the fourth quarter. Stone back the line. Second one, no good. Rebound comes off to Korn. Holland up the right side. Cyrus Holland stops. Back out. Seth Korn, top of the key. Dribbles. Goes left. Stops. Pops. Shot in the lane. No good. Rebound tipped around. Pulled back in by Korn. Turnaround jumper on the baseline is good. Nice soft touch there from Seth Korn, the senior. And it's a 68-39 Plymouth lead. Parkhurst, top of the key, dribbles off. Baseline jumper on the way from Anders. Air ball, long. Rebound comes off to Houdeshell. Fumbling the ball a little bit, pulls it back in. Skips it over to Alec Holland. He's going to skip it across. Odell, in the post. Good recovery by Matt Flynn to tip the ball out of bounds. And it's going to be stay with the Zebras on this end. This score, and we're still seeing some good effort from both teams right now.
Yeah, good to see the young guys from Plymouth are playing hard, and the Zebra Stars are still playing hard, trying to salvage something, get something out of this game.
Riles back into the Plymouth lineup as the Zebras inbound to Houdeshell, gives it back to Alec Holland, dribbles back out to the circle to reset the offense. Houdeshell left wing, dribbling back out of it. Good pressure from the Plymouth defense right now. Right wing, Cyrus Holland steps over. Long two on the way, no good, and it's going to go out of bounds off of Rochester. So it's Plymouth ball here. 4:13 remaining in the fourth quarter as the Zebras will stick with their trap defense. Flynn picks it up just beyond midcourt, throws it ahead to Anders, who turns around, tries to lay it in. No good, but he is fouled on the shot. There's another foul coming on the Zebras, and it was on. We're going to get Cyrus Holland with the foul, his second, with 4:01 remaining in the fourth. First free throw on the way from Anders is no good, and he'll have a second one coming here. 29-point lead here for the Pilgrims as they look to move ahead to 3-0 on the season. Zebras are going to fall to 0-2. Second one no good. Rebound comes off to Houdeshell. Throws it ahead to Korn. Korn left wing throws it ahead. Alec Holland. Alec Holland under the bucket. Shot is easily rejected by Anders. And they're going to get a foul. That was not a foul, though.
I think that was a pretty clean block.
Yeah, and Anders much taller than
I think they're just
Alec loved, Holland.
I think they just love the effort of the little guy and give him
yeah.
out.
By little guy right now, do you mean Holland or do you mean the Rochester offense right now? Because it's been struggling.
Basically, Gibby said they're the same thing.
From the freshman, no good, in and out, and rebound comes off to Anders. Now Flynn pushing it the other way. The right wing takes it down, slips, falls, travels. We've seen a little bit of slipping tonight. I'm not sure if it's the court or just because some of these guys have been going a little too hard at times.
Yeah, well, this court is pretty old. I know we have the same problem. I know both the teams don't always like playing here.
It's an old gymnasium, and we love it here at Rochester. 3:38 remaining fourth quarter. Zebras with the ball, left wing. Houdeshell up top. Holland three on the way. No good. Rebound. Pulled in by Odell. Putback is no good. Rebound to Bryles. Now the trap comes from Odell as Bryles breaks the pressure. And we're going to get a travel on Bryles as Odell gave a little too much pressure and he shuffled his feet. 28-point lead here for the Pilgrims. 68-40. This is the closest it's been actually in quite a while. Probably early in the third was the last time we've seen it this close. With 3:16 remaining in the game. Odell with the ball at the volleyball line. Looks right side, finds Houdeshell. Houdeshell looking in the post to Cyrus Holland. Decides not to, now he dribbles baseline. Cut off. And we're going to get a foul on Cyrus Holland, who gets a little aggressive in the post with Anders. And he's going to pick up his third foul. Kennedy's going to check back in, and out of show will take a seat. Parkhurst to inbound for the Pilgrims. 3 minutes remaining. Pilgrims lead 68-40 over the Zebras. Back into the half-court trap, headed by Cyrus Holland and John Odell. Left side, this is Stone for Plymouth. Now back to Flynn. Flynn dribbles down. Corner now to Anders. Anderson right to the bucket. Layup, no good. Rebound comes off to Alec Holland. Holland the other way. Right side, Seth Thornton jump stops in the corner. Puts it back on the floor, runs middle. Back out, Odell, an NBA three on the way, no good. Rebound tipped around, and Kennedy, well, he had it, lost it, back on the floor, now they're scrubbing for it. Odell comes up with it, tough shot, standing on the floor, falling down, off the glass is good. And this might be the definition of garbage time right now, Jason.
Yeah, a nice play by Odell that would have followed a shot, and I'm sure Ryan Holt wouldn't be too thrilled with the NBA three right now. He's probably looking more to get some kind of offensive rhythm going, at least get something going for future games.
Plymouth underneath the bucket, and it's going to go off the foot of Anders out of bounds. Goes to the Zebras with 2:10 remaining in the game.
You know, as a sophomore, you play JV, just varsity. These are moments you live for, getting in the scorebook.
Screeton checks back in. Cyrus Holland takes a seat as he takes down to the short corner on the left side. Out to Alec Holland. Top of the key is Kennedy. Kennedy looking for Odell. Finds him right wing. He dribbles baseline. Takes it into the defense. Kicks it back out. Now Holland puts on the floor. Stops. Pops in. It's good. 68-44 Plymouth. Browns against the pressure. Ball is loose. On the floor. Picked up Odell. Odell, one against two the other way. He's going to take it right at him. Laying in and good. And Coach Bales wants a timeout. He wants to slow us down. Even with a minute 38 left and a 22-point lead, he's feeling he's getting away from him a little bit. So he's going to take a quick 30-second timeout. So we'll use this opportunity to mention that in the JV game. Plymouth did defeat Rochester 32-23, but Rochester came back actually 6 points at the half. A pretty big third quarter brought him right back in that game. It was a good contest.
Yeah, it was a pretty good contest. A game that turned out much like this. Low scoring in the first half for the Zebras, but we do have some finals in the air. McConnell 80-58 over North Miami. And in a thriller, Coach Jim Metcalf, former Zebra coach, gets his first win at Peru with an 87-84 overtime win with Logan Prime Urbano hitting 3-point at buzzer, which gives Zebras some troubles over the years, that name. But big win for Coach Metcalf down there at Peru.
That's a very good win because Wabash is in some pushover this year. They're going to try to compete.
They had a real breakthrough last year.
Yep. They're going to compete for the title this year in the TRC. So back to action. Minute and a half remaining as Plymouth is working against the pressure. Lob ahead to Anders near the baseline. Back out to Bryles. He's going to skip a right side. They're going to swing it. Actually, Flynn's going to pull it back out. Now to the elbow. Now skipped across. Bryles three from the corner. Way long. Rebound comes off to Stone. His footback's no good. Rebound on the floor. Pulled away by Korn. Now to Screeton. He's going to back it back out for the Zebras. Minute 8 remaining here in the game. Korn right side up top. Alec Holland. He dribbles over. 15-foot jumper is no good. It's blocked. So they're going to get another foul. That's probably another one I probably would have let go, honestly.
Yeah, but good to see the freshman get to the line. Chance to make it a 20-point ball game. Hasn't been that close since, what, second quarter?
Zebras have really bowed their way back, and, you know, usually you don't see a big difference in garbage time and that sort of thing, but they're playing for pride right now, and they're doing a, you know, pretty good job of it. Minute 1 remaining in the fourth after Holland hits his first. He's got a second coming, and it's good. And it's a 20-point lead. Closest it's been since the second quarter. Both teams in the double bonus right now, 55 seconds remaining. You hope there's no more fouls. Bryles trapped in the corner. Here comes the pressure from the Zebras. Picks it up, skips it over Flynn. Now short corner. This is Stone. He's going to go up. He's going to be ripped to the floor by Kennedy. And one. Gets the bucket to fall. That was a tough bucket. Kennedy probably fortunately ain't called for an intentional foul there. So Stone's going to head to the line to shoot his bonus free throw here. With 45.5 seconds remaining in the game. Free throw on the way is in and out, no good. Rebound tipped around. pulled in by Korn, gives it ahead to Screeden, who lobs it down the court. Alec Holland back to Odell. Odell's shot is no good, but he is fouled, and he'll head to the line to shoot two. 38.4 seconds remaining in a 70-48 game. Plymouth leads. He was looking to try to get to 50 points here. As Odell heads the line to shoot two. That was the fourth on Bryles. Free throw on the way. It rattles home good. He'll have another one coming here. Like we said earlier, the Zebras are going to fall to 0-2 tonight. And the Pilgrims, ranked 11th in 3A, are going to move to 3-0. Second one is no good. 70-49 is the score. Adelshell went to the scorer's table to check in, but he's not going to get into the game. As the clock runs, 25 seconds.
He would have.
Yeah, 26 seconds remaining. We're going to get a foul.
Yeah, we could go 8 seconds without a foul in this ball game.
No, not so far we haven't. Zebras, next on the schedule, they're going to be playing at Winnemac on Tuesday. We'll have that game for you. As the Pilgrims will move to their next opponent, will be South Bend St. Joseph's, at South Bend St. Joseph's on Tuesday also. First one is good from Bryles. Sends the lead to 22 as he has the second one coming. No good. We're in and out. Rebound. Tipped around. Knocked out of bounds off of Plymouth. And it will go to the Zebras with 24.1 seconds remaining. Zebras are going to run a play here as Screeden brings it up the court. 71-49 is the score right now. Korn, right wing, looking in the post for Kennedy. Now he's going to go up top to Odell. Odell, three on the way. Good! And 71-52 is the score, 10 seconds remaining. I believe they can, they got across the timeline here. Gets it over, Bryles across the timeline. 2-1, and that is your ball game. Final score here from Rochester High School. Plymouth Pilgrims, 71. The Rochester Zebras, 52.